news of the impending descent to the earth of the great savior Mahavir reaches every corner, and Indra, king of gods, seated in his heavenly court, hears of it too. The painter sets out here to capture the joyous atmosphere of the heavenly court, filling the shimmering page not only with looming lustrous figure of Indra, attended upon by fly whisk bearers and receiving the homage of two men who await his orders, but with row upon animated row of women dancers and musicians. This richly colored and startlingly stylized folio comes from a now dispersed manuscript of Shahnama, Firdausi's great Persian epic. The work bears no date except that on the seal of a late owner, there is no indication of where it was written or painted. No name of painter or patron appears. The text is all in Persian, written in four columns on pages of a vertical codex. Yet the style of the painting is far from Persian. This work, however, has a distinctly different flavor and has many elements of style that come from a pronouncedly Indian native source, almost certainly Jain. The manuscript raises important questions of context and attitude and might have a deep bearing on our understanding of what was happening in the world of painting during the Sultanate period, a time which has been relatively less explored by art historians. In this picture, the young prince Siavash of Iran, to the left of the image, arrives with his contingent to meet Afrasiab, king of Turan, who with his companions stations himself on the other bank of the river Jihun. Negotiations are in progress, as indicated by the hands which are extended as if in conversation. Nothing in it is quite like what one is used to seeing in the usual Shahnama illustrations. The delineation of the river reduced here to a slim stream, the toy-like horses, the uniform direction of glances, the helmets with camels and corselets of chainmail are all very different. The color glow, the form appears heroic, and the tension of the moment is palpable.